Yo, guys, this is Red Yoshi here. I am here to give you a demo video over the Jack-O-Lantern Jamborees 1, 2, and 3, plus some extras that I'll be showing you. So, if you don't know, not only is the Jack-O-Lantern Jamboree supported, they aren't the only ones that are meant for pumpkins. Like, there are also other ones that you'll be seeing soon in a second that you can actually project onto pumpkins, and they actually look really cool, so... the only things I won't be able to show in this video are the Jack-O-Lantern Jamboree 3 songs, and that is due to copyright problems that I'll probably get if I do show them. But the three songs that they do sing are Ghostbusters, The Addams Family, and Monster Mash. So, yeah, without further ado, I'll show you everything else.
This is a tale of three children bold. On one Halloween night, stormy and cold. Too much candy from their neighbors they did take. It is known that their greed set their fate. All the village's treats they did amass, except one last house whose gates no one would pass. To this spooky old mansion the craving children went. To the last of the town's candy, they were fast on its scent. Along a path of shattered slate they cautiously walked. Greeted by cawing ravens and a black cat that stalked. Clang, 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 the cauldron-shaped doorknocker rang. Creak, 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 the giant oak door slowly swang. Standing before them was the cutest child, almost their age. With a wink and a wave, he invited them into his magnificent Victorian cage. To his parlor they followed, where an enormous mound of sweet treats they did greet.
Where did you get all this candy?
The children dared to ask.
I took it from the good townspeople. 'Twas quite a task. Here, why don't you have some?
He offered, presenting a tattered old sack. Several pieces they took, smelled, and tasted. But moments later, they began to gag and hack. The children cried.
It tastes like shoe leather and slugs mixed into a stale dough.
I'm not surprised,
the boy said,
as I stole it nearly a century ago or so.
The children's mouths agape, they did fear. What is this boy thing standing far, far too near? And for the first time he did smile, exposing teeth yellow, pointed, and vile.
Ew. And with those bites, you now share my plight. To live in this mansion for eternal night.
The thick doors groaned loudly and slowly began to shut.
Uh-oh.
The children raced for their freedom, faster than any hunter's hungry mutt. What of their fate? Did they escape? No one knows, but have no fear. At least the town's candy is safe, and shall never again disappear.
Thank you.
joke for you. What's a skeleton's favorite meal?
I don't know what.
Give up. Spare ribs. Wait, I got another one. What do skeletons say before every meal?
What do they say?
Bon appetit. Get it?
Oh.
Skeleton.
Oh, that's a good one.
Scary. We'll feast your ears on this.
Give me to prepare to be truly scarified.
Step right up, step right up. Don't be shy, boys and girls, goblins and ghouls. Only those brave enough to venture to the door will collect their reward. But beware the strange specters who haunt these ghoulish grounds. Horrors so shocking, sweets so savory. Come one, come all!
Happy Halloween, everyone! Welcome to our humble haunted home.
Don't be so humble, Timmy. After all, this is the scariest house on the block.
Did you say scariest? Oh, no.
Absolutely. Have you seen the humans that live here?
Ugh.
Well, their candy ain't so scary.
No, not bad at all.
Hey, kid.
Won't you take a piece of candy, please?
If you dare.
Speaking of candy, that reminds me. We need to explain the rules.
No, I hate rules.
Okay. First rule, only one piece of candy each.
Are you there with a bat the size of a full-grown troll? I'm talking to you.
There might be something other than candy in that sack.
Oh, second rule, you need to be wearing a costume to get a piece of candy.
You tell him, Tippy. Look, check out that kid over there. Now that's a frightening-looking costume.
Squashy? That's an adult, and I don't think they're wearing a costume.
Well, that's hideous, whatever they're wearing.
And last but not least, the final rule. Don't blow out your jack-o'-lantern until Halloween is officially over.
Why? What will happen?
Oh, you don't want to find out. It's something really, really scary.
Something scary like this.
Surely it couldn't be scarier
than this!
Hey, you want to see something really scary? Check out that spooky-looking ghost hovering over there.
There! There's the scary ghost!
They just blew that kid's hat off. What a windbag! Hey, you broke one of the rules. Oh yeah? Well, one. I need two completed that game.
Ha! Too easy. Too easy.
Yes! I win! I bested them both.
That'll learn them.
Now, back to business. That ghost is really getting on my vines.
Yeah, that guy's full of hot air. So what do we do?
We need to call for help.
Who are we gonna call?
Well, now that I see it in the light of the moon, it is quite impressive. I don't think that kid's wearing a mask.
With a face like that, who needs a mask?
Your bag's looking kind of heavy there, kid. Want to share some of that candy?
Then why don't you just leave it with us?
We'll take good care of it for you.
I have an idea. Maybe we can scare the kids into dropping their sacks of candy. On the count of three, make your scariest face. One, two. Impressive. That didn't even scare Dippy, and he's scared of his own shadow.
Shadow? Shadow? Where? Where?
Oh, boy.
Not again.
Quick, we have to distract him. Hey, Dippy, look over there at that rock.
Ooh, a rock. Where? Where?
That was a close one.
Hey, kid. Kid, what are you supposed to be?
Ew, is that supposed to be its head or its tail?
Beats me. I thought it was some trash the neighbors had left out.
You there. Weren't you here earlier?
Move on.
Yeah, respect the Halloween rules.
One piece of candy each.
Oh my goblin! What is that monstrosity?
I believe they call it a princess.
So bright! So shiny!
Oh, the horror! The horror!
Oh, look! Here comes a really furry one!
Wow, it's even walking on four legs!
Why is it dragging that human behind it on a leash?
I don't know, but he sure is slobbery! Hey, back off, creature! Put that tongue away!
Oh, brother, here comes a real winner. Is that a costume, or are you just wearing your baseball uniform?
Yeah, you really struck out there, kid. Ooh, check out the alien.
I think that's a zombie, Squashy.
Hey, I'm no zombie, Dickie.
That's not an alien or a zombie, or even a zombie Squashy. It's just Fred, the next door neighbor.
Hell yeah! Hey, Fred!
How you doing there, Fred?
Aw, look at that one! So cute!
Dippy, that is actually just a bush.
Oh, definitely a bush.
Oh, wow! Now that is the best costume of the night.
Ooh, which one?
A miniature bald human riding in that chariot.
Incredible! And how about that scream? So wonderfully blood-curdling.
And loud. Also very, very loud.
He's stinky.
So many great costumes. So much fun. I wish every night was Halloween.
Me too.
Me free.
Happy Halloween, everyone! Happy, happy, happy Halloween!
Bum 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 bum. The smell of leaves is in the air and how the full moon shines. It's such a thrill to feel the chill run straight down through your spine. Our favorite night of all the year, we can't believe it's here. Oh, Halloween's the perfect scene to spread some fun and fear. It's the night when ghouls delight and ghosts come out to play.
As darkness grows, our pumpkin's blood is there to light the way.
Tonight the living and the dead can sing in harmony. So organize your grand disguise and join our jamboree. You can masquerade as anything you wish or dream.
Like something really scary that will make your neighbors scream.
Dress up like a pirate or an angel all in light.
Or be a gruesome monster that will give them all a fright.
Trick or treat
it's time to greet the strangers at your door. Let's fill their sacks with sweets and snacks, there's always room for more. So don't hold back or they'll attack and prank your house all night. Halloween's a night that's filled with wonder and surprise,
and creatures in the shadows that are plotting you in your eyes.
Tonight we all can face the dark and prove we're unafraid,
until the screaming corpse pops out all rotten and decayed.
Take some rats and decorate with bombs. To get more fright, we'll dim the lights and let out eerie moans. Our fearsome fun has just begun, but midnight's drawing near. Oh, why can't Halloween be more than one night of the year? Why can't Halloween be more than one night of the
Ages ago in lore of old, the rise of a champion did unfold.
Ooh.
A gourd that would ward in every way, a very, very special day. It was a somber and sober last day of October, in a hollow patch where our hero did hatch. He did not sprout from any magic bean, nor was he summoned by some fairy queen.
Uh-huh.
It was the perfect storm of fate and date that makes his appearance so very great. Lightning struck the ancient ground with a loud, booming, thunderous sound. And upon that scorched and smoldering spot, our shining patron was begot.
What?
But this was no ordinary village bumpkin, for it had the body of a boy and the head of a pumpkin.
Aw, isn't that cute?
His back never bowed, and pace never slowed, as he strode down many a winding road. Traversing dark, deep holes and tall, steep knolls, he kept steadfast to his one true goal.
Ooh.
Of spreading his love from pole to pole, of all Hallows' Eve wonders to every spirit and soul.
Nice.
To see his way through the dead of night, he placed in his head a candle so bright.
Yeah.
And to stave off the weather's gloom, he fashioned and wore a splendid costume.
That's right.
Sharing his joy was the oath he had sworn. And all those he met received sweet candied corn.
Yummy!
Before one journey around the sun, a new tradition was formed of ghoulish good fun. And on the night we now call Halloween, these three practices must remain keen. Upon the sun's fading light, put out a jack-o'-lantern shining bright.
Three.
Embrace the spirit of the night, dress up and share a laugh, or even a fright.
Ooh.
And to all fellow revelers you happen to meet, be sure to share a delicious treat.
Very delicious.
Now before our story comes to an end, one more thing to know about our fine friend. In his heart there's no room for hate, and thus all holidays he loves to celebrate.
Ah, that's swell.
But as you, and you, and you might have guessed, a Lord of the Gourds loves Halloween best.
Yeah!
Now it's time for some spooky jokes about ghosts.
What is a kid ghost's favorite drink?
Kool-Aid.
Give up?
Kool-Aid!
Hilarious.
Yep, nothing. Alright, here, how about this one? Why did the ghost win the beauty pageant?
I don't know, why?
Because she was beautiful. Get it? Because ghosts say boo. You're gonna love this one. What kind of trousers do ghosts prefer?
I don't know, what kind?
Scaredy pants! Ah, come on, these are gold!
tonight is Halloween, and we're prepared to make you scream. Our faces carved and candles charged, our wicked power and wounds played large. Strikes midnight, the witches arise for their annual flight. They'll take to the skies through the moon's haunting glow, flying high, waving bye to their subjects below. As they sail through the air without caution or care, you'd be wise not to spy, or you might get a scare. Tonight is Halloween, when ghosts and goblins enjoy being seen. They seek your treats, your tasty sweets, the ones you've collected while roaming the streets. They'll sniff you out, search high and low. They have a sweet tooth, don't you know? And if they cannot find your loot, they just might eat you as a substitute. Time to hide, better run, close your eyes, hold my tongue. You just might have a fright by the time this night's done. If they hear you are near, they'll be troubled, my dears. You will come face to face with the worst of your fears. It's no use to plea, though it would give them glee, as you suffer the horrors of their stealing spree. If they hear you are near, they'll be troubled, my dears. You will come face to face with the worst of your fears.
Once upon a night, while I wandered over many a quaint and dreary spot, a forgotten lore, while I non-hearing islands, there came a tap, as of someone gently rapping at my chamber door. Separate dying ember, what its ghost upon the floor. Eagerly I wished the morrow, vainly I had sought to borrow, but my books assist sorrow for the loss of the poor. Here, a radiant maid, whom the angels name Lenore, names here or in the hall. A silken sad and a certain rustling of its purple curtain, thrilled me with fantastic tears never felt before. Till it now to still the beating of my ear, I stood repeating, 'tis some visitor entreating entrance at my chamber door. This is it, and nothing more. Presently my soul grew stronger, hesitating then no longer. Sir, said I, or madam, your forgiveness I implore.
But the fact is, I was napping, so gently
you came rapping, and so faintly you came tapping, tapping at my chamber door, that I scarce was sure I could do. Wide the door. Darkness there, and nothing more. Back into the temple turning, the soul within me burning. Soon again I heard a tiny sound clearer than before. Slowly, said I, surely that is something that the Lord is. You see them, what their act is. Explore. And there stepped the stately raven of the saintly days of yore. Not the least obeisance made he, not a minute stopped or stayed he, with his mien of lord or lady, perched above my chamber door, perched upon a bust of palace just above my chamber door.
It's no use to hide, they're sure to find you. Don't turn around, they're creeping up behind you. Hobnobbing goblins terrorize with hideous grins and grim glowing eyes. Some tall and thin, some short and stout. They'll rap on your door and you will hear them shout out, trick or treat, and smell our feet, and give us something good to eat. Cause if you don't, you will despair as we serve up a very special scare.
Yeah.
Goblins enjoy making frightful faces meant to unnerve and to terrify. Crafting the most clever hiding places, waiting in the dark for someone to walk by. Underneath your bed, creeping in the shed, is that a goblin right above your head? Hobnobbing goblins are most merry, waltzing around in a cemetery, raising the roof in a mausoleum, tangoing on tombstones, tap dancing with demons. Goblins are a fright. They do delight in getting to what scares you. Bouts a slobbering candy goblin, lock the door if they start mobbing. Hearts are throbbing, knees go wobbling when these goblins come hobnobbing. You beware, best take care. Goblins love to scare, beware.
The moon shone bright o'er the new-fallen leaves, and shadows lurked about like mischievous thieves. When out on the lawn there arose eerie laughter, I sprang from my perch to see what it was after. And what to my hollowed-out eyes should appear but a group of small children with motives unclear. Tiny tots all dressed up as goblins and ghouls, carting sacks full of candy like sure-footed mules. They filled me with fear, this gruesome young gang, as they crept to my door, and in unison they sang,
"Trick or treat, smell my feet, give us something good to eat. If you don't, we will delight in haunting your house this Halloween night."
I spoke not a word, but just quickly obeyed, tossing handfuls of candy to this beastly brigade. Content with their spoils, they closed up their sacks, then turned from my door and quickly made tracks. But I heard them exclaim as they scattered from sight,
"Happy Halloween to all, and to all
demons go. They all have good reason to shy and steer clear of that spooky abode and its dark atmosphere. For when inside are all manner of frights, especially on those cold, dark, and stormy nights. It lays in ruin, run down, and overgrown. But to goblins and ghosts is what haunts we all. Welcome to our haunted house. Step right in, don't loiter about. The ghosts are dying to give you a tour down every dank and dark corridor. The shadows whisper and the floorboards creak, and every cobweb's hung with care. We've done our best to keep it cold and bleak,
so you'll be primed for every scare.
House. Round each bend, something waits to pop out. A thousand horrors are lurking within to frighten you right out of your skin. A phantom's hiding beneath that old bedspread. A severed hand across the floor. Our basement's loaded with the living dead.
Specters by the score.
Welcome to our haunted house. Ghosts can be real.
Even though you're having your doubts.
Just spend the night here. We'll prove it to you by making all your nightmares come true.
It's bound to scare you.
When you see a ghostly review,
we double dare you.
Don't be daunted. Brave our haunted house. Bum, bum, bum. What a
once a year the full moon looms, children dress in costumes.
Jack-o'-lanterns come alive and sing this foolish tune.
Witches fly upon their brooms, spirits rise from their tombs.
Creatures of the night will hunt for candy to consume.
Little kitties all beware of fearsome frights and sneaky scares.
Ghosts and goblins prowl about to catch you unaware.
Better find a good disguise to blend in if you're wise.
Go from door to door and you'll collect a sweet surprise.
Crawly slime and goo, werewolves howl and zombies drool. Something's waiting in the dark to jump out and yell woo. Monsters roaming everywhere, tag along if you dare. You will have a night of fright and fun beyond compare. Once again, full moon glooms, children dress in costumes. Jack-o'-lanterns
There was a doubting boy from Maine who thought Halloween was quite lame. But one day he found out that candy was about, and now he's a trick-or-treater of fame. There is a sassy girl named Sue who frequently shouts out, "Boo!" She always tricks before treat, asks you to smell her feet, then pulls out some candy to chew. There was a giant pumpkin called Randall, who created quite the scandal. He could always be found for miles around by the brightness of his candle. There once was a very sad zombie who would often cry for her mommy. In a state of alarm at the loss of her arm, she replaced it with a salami. Had a head like a pumpkin, and seemed to be quite a bumpkin, but he was actually smart, with a really big heart, and told jokes that made everyone grin. There was a peculiar man named Scones, who liked to collect old bones. To the cemetery he'd go, searching high and low, amongst all the crumbling tombstones. There once was an arrogant ghost, who would travel from coast to coast. All the kids he would scare, for as long as he dare, or so the smug spirit would boast. There once was a girl named Nadine, whose favorite day was Halloween. She wore a magic cape that she made from a drape, and gathered sweet candy unseen.
There once was a pumpkin named Scorch, who loved to hang out on the porch. Throughout all the night, he'd shine very bright, with a flame that burned like a torch. It's Halloween tonight, an evening full of fright. Goblins, ghoulies, we all yell boo. The night we've all awaited, the homes are decorated. Troll masks, candy sacks, we all get treats. The witch has cast a spell, what's that awful smell? A monster, a zombie, we all yell boo. The moon is full and bright, the pumpkins are alight. Disguises, surprises, we all get treats. The crow up on the steeple is screeching at the people. Black cats, winged bats, we all yell boo. The doorbells are all ringing, the boys and girls are singing. Candy, candy, we all get treats. The creepy crawly spider climbed up the iron gate. Up at the top it would meet an awful fate. Out came the moon and made the werewolves howl, and the creepy crawly spider got eaten by an owl. Look! The squeaking, squawking raven flew up the old dead tree. The night grew so dark that the raven couldn't see. Strong blew the wind and knocked the old tree down, and the squeaking, squawking raven was never to be found. Hissing, kissing snake slithered out an open grave, looking for a snack and the chance to misbehave. Out popped a hand and grabbed him by the tail, and the hissing, kissing snake turned a whiter shade of pale. The fat black cat pranced across the old fence post, stopped dead in its tracks when it saw an eerie ghost. Loud clap of thunder scared the ghost away, and the fat black cat lived to see another day.
All houses wherein people have lived and died are haunted houses. Through the open doors, the harmless phantoms on their errands glide, with feet that make no sound upon the floors. We meet them at the doorway, on the stair, along the passages they come and go. Impalpable impressions on the air, a sense of something moving to and fro. There are more guests at the table than the hosts invited. The illuminated hall is thronged with quiet, inoffensive ghosts, as silent as the pictures on the wall. The stranger at my fireside cannot see the forms I see, nor hear the sounds I hear. He but perceives what is, while unto me all that has been is visible and clear. We have no title deeds to house or lands, owners and occupants of earlier dates. From graves forgotten stretch their dusty hands, and hold in pining still their old estates. The spirit world around this world of sense floats like an atmosphere, and everywhere wafts through these earthly mists and vapors dense a vital breath of more ethereal air. Our little lives are kept in equipoise by opposite attractions and desires. The struggle of the instinct that enjoys and the more noble instinct that aspires.
as the moon from some dark gate of cloud throws o'er the sea a floating bridge of light, across whose trembling planks our fancies crowd, into the realm of mystery and night. So from the world of spirits there descends a bridge of light connecting it with this, or whose unsteady floor that sways and bends wander our thoughts above the dark abyss. Tells the tale of the disappearance of Ichabod Crane, schoolmaster of Sleepy Hollow, the very same unfortunate Ichabod who encountered the ghost of a Hessian soldier whose body is buried in the town churchyard. The specter is known at all the country firesides by the name of the Headless Horseman of Sleepy Hollow. It was the very witching time of night that Ichabod pursued his travels homewards. No signs of life occurred to him, but occasionally the melancholy chirp of a cricket. All the stories of ghosts and goblins that he had heard now came crowding upon his recollection. The night grew darker and darker. A small brook crossed the road and ran into a thickly wooded glen. A few rough logs laid side by side served as a bridge over this stream. To pass this bridge was the severest trial. This has ever since been considered a haunted stream. As he approached, his heart began to thump. He summoned up all his resolution and attempted to dash briskly across the bridge. Ichabod jerked the reins, and his horse, Gunpowder, plunged to the opposite side of the road into a thicket of brambles. He then dashed forward and came to a stand by the bridge with a suddenness that had nearly sent the schoolmaster sprawling over his head. Just at this moment, a splash by the side of the bridge caught the ear of Ichabod. In the dark shadows of the grove, he beheld something huge, misshapen and towering. It stirred not, but seemed gathered up in gloom. The hair of Ichabod rose upon his head with terror. What was to be done? To turn and fly, 'twas now too late. Besides, what chance was there of escaping ghost or goblin, if such it was? Then the shadowy object of alarm put itself in motion. With a scramble and a bound, stood at once in the middle of the road. He appeared to be a horseman of large dimensions, and mounted on a black horse of powerful frame. Ichabod quickened his steed, hopes of leaving him behind. The stranger, however, quickened his horse to an equal pace. Ichabod pulled up and fell into a walk, thinking to lag behind. The other did the same. On mounting a rising ground, which brought the figure of his fellow traveler in relief against the sky, Ichabod was horror-struck on perceiving that he was headless. But his horror was still more increased on observing that the head, which should have rested on his shoulders, was carried before him on the pommel of his saddle. His terror rose to desperation. Away then they dashed through the thick and the thin, stones flying, sparks flashing at every bound. Ichabod's flimsy garments fluttered in the air as he stretched his long, lank body away over the horse's head in the eagerness of his flight. They had now reached the road which turns off to Sleepy Hollow. The Gunpowder, who seemed possessed with a demon, made an opposite turn and plunged headlong downhill to the left. This road led over a bridge to a green knoll on which stands a church. The panic of the steed had given his unskillful rider an apparent advantage in the chase. An opening in the trees now cheered him with the hopes that the church bridge was at hand. For once he crossed that very bridge, the ghost's power would surely end. Just then, he heard the black steed panting and blowing close behind him. He even fancied that he felt his heart breath. Old Gunpowder sprang upon the bridge. He thundered over the resounding planks. He gave the opposite side, and now Ichabod cast a look behind to see if the pursuer should vanish. Just then, he saw the goblin rising in his stirrups in the very act of hurling his head at him. Ichabod endeavored to dodge the horrible missile, but too late. It encountered his cranium with a tremendous crash. He was tumbled headlong into the dust. The gunpowder, the black steam, and the goblin rider passed by like a whirlwind. The next morning, the old horse was found soberly cropping the grass at his master's gate. Dinner hour came, but no Ichabod. The boys assembled at the schoolhouse and strolled idly about the banks of the brook, but no schoolmaster. And after diligent investigation, they came upon his traces on the bank of a broad part of the brook, where the water ran deep and black, was found the hat of the unfortunate Ichabod, and close beside it, a shattered pumpkin.
So much fun, so much fun. Halloween is so much fun. Trick or treating. Will I be a clown or ghost? Clown or ghost, clown or ghost. Will I be a clown or ghost? Choose a costume. Fill my sack with candy bars, candy bars, candy bars. Fill my sack with candy bars, so much candy. Now I have a stomach ache, stomach ache, stomach ache. Now I have a stomach ache, so much candy. Halloween is so much fun, so much fun, so much fun. Halloween is so much fun, trick or treating.
So yeah, guys, that is all the Jack-O-Lantern Jamboree scenes that you can get for your pumpkins this year. Again, they just released the third one this year, so I have all of them. And let me know what you guys think of them. Are you going to be getting these for your own display? Let me know in the comments below how you think of them. And of course, like, comment, and subscribe, guys. See you later.